The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... The flow of the river is ceaseless, but the water is never the same. The bubbles that float in the pools, now forming, now vanishing, are only of short duration. So in this eternally changing world is man. He is born in the morning, he dies in the evening, like foam upon the water. Nothing is ever the same. But nothing ever changes.
Do you think the two of us can go to the hills and start the revolution?
25 years ago, two people went into the hills and did that very thing. You and my father.
You forget I am old now. You are hardly more than a boy.
And you forget that my father died to set you free, so that one day...
I did not ask him to set me free.
You would have perished in that prison. I'm leaving on Friday. With you... or without you?
You would go alone?
25 years ago, you would have gone alone.
Our mystery drama, The Hills of Arias, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars Mandel Kramer. I'll be back shortly with Act One. The Bible says, your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions. Yes, that tells us about the old and the young, but nowhere is mention made of the middle-aged. What do they behold in that interval of life that stretches between vision and dream? Reality, perhaps?
Use my mind. I must bend it, stretch it. I must keep teaching my classes. Yes, yes. I must create a new course. I always wanted to teach a seminar. Yes. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We shall be concerned with the subconscious mind in literature. We shall read Shakespeare, Hawthorne, Poe, and Freud. For those of you who can read English and German...
Francisco Canavas.
Yes.
What are you doing?
I'm teaching my class.
You are, huh? Well, dismiss them for the day, and let's go.
Go? Go where? You always beat me up in here.
A change of scene might do us both some good.
Am I to be shot?
Come on.
You could at least have the decency to tell me.
Why would you want to know?
I would like to pray.
Well, pray anyhow. It won't go two ways.
Halt!
Guard Diaz, chauffeur Escobar, and prisoner Canovas reporting on orders.
Open the gate. Pass through.
It is the palace. The presidential palace.
Yes.
Why am I being brought here?
What's the matter? You got something better to do? Go in there.
But it is dark.
Inside.
No. Oh, where?
Dr. Francisco Cadevas. In exactly 5 seconds, you shall be shot for the crimes you have committed against the revolution. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Turn on the light. Turn on the light. Yes, Cisco, It was just a joke. Go sit down. See what a sumptuous table I've prepared. A feast fit for the gods. Here, a glass of champagne, huh? Drink. You have every right to be angry, Cisco. It was a cruel joke. I'm sorry. I'm sorry I brought you here tonight. But I brought you here tonight because I want us to work together again. The way we did in the beginning, when it was our revolution. Why not? All right, it was a terrible joke, Sister. Oh, I'm sorry. I said I was sorry.
You have so many things to be sorry for, Kelo. How do you keep track? Do you enter them in a book?
One of us had to become absolute dictator. You refused. I made the sacrifice.
Poor Kelo.
I don't deserve your sarcasm.
What do you deserve?
Compassion. Understanding. I gave up everything. My wife, my daughter, my friends. Who would believe today that I once wrote poetry? Isabella, Serafina, Elisabetta, and Christina. Lovely ladies, pity me.
Do not make me choose among you. In gaining one, I am losing three.
Oh, Cisco, you remember, you remember.
Why don't you kill me, Kelo?
I'm not a good dictator.
Nonsense. You are a splendid dictator.
No. A dictator must purge himself of all mercy, sentiment, humanity.
You have no mercy, sentiment, humanity, Kelo.
Except for you, Cisco. You're my only weakness. I can't kill you. I'll let you live. Even though I know one day you'll escape. You'll raise the army that will overthrow me.
No, my strength is gone. My mind is going. Soon I will be dead.
Tonight. For just an hour. You and I. We must forget everything except that we were friends. Let's eat. Drink.
No.
Cisco. Cisco, I must talk with somebody. Argue with somebody. And they're all afraid of me. Let's cross swords the way we used to, huh? Please. I understand. But eat something.
I cannot.
To punish me?
No.
Then why?
I don't remember. My memory. It comes, it goes. Perhaps the guard might know.
Guard!
Here's my leader.
The man is obviously starving. Here is a table laden with wonderful things to eat. Why does he refuse to eat them?
He does. Take some bread and water, my leader.
Let me go back, Kelo.
Go back. Go back. I shall know better than to try to be kind to you again.
Well, Canovas, you sure fouled that one up.
Are you going to be angry with me?
All my life I was sorry I never went to college. But I look at you, I'm not so sure. Here you are, Dr. Francisco Canovas. They say you're the greatest scholar in the history of the country. You should have gotten the Nobel Prize. You're not too smart.
That is true. I am not too smart.
You know what being smart is? Being smart means knowing how to keep alive. What do you want to die for?
There are times when life is no longer worth living.
Hey. Hey, what's up ahead?
Roadblock.
Oh, now what?
Oh!
Watch up!
Security check! Step out!
Look, my friend. Here, my ID.
Out!
I'm with the special forces. You can't...
Step out!
Hey, wait a minute. You're not...
Now, Luis! Now! Hurry, Chico! Get out of the car!
The guard! The chauffeur! Chico,
quickly!
Why did you kill them?
Luis, Paco, help him out!
They were not bad fellows, misguided perhaps.
Shuttle had every police patrol down on us.
Who are you?
It's me, Cipriano. And Luis, and Paco.
Where are we going?
Down to the beach. A boat should be waiting. Hurry!
I cannot walk so far.
Luis, Paco, help him! Let's go!
Where are you taking me?
The boat will take you to the United States.
Why?
Why? So you can fight for us from there.
I'm tired. I'm so tired.
Speak for us. Write for us. As only you can.
I cannot go any further. Where are you?
Courage, Cisco.
I cannot.
And there's the boat.
The police. They see us.
Hurry! Stop it!
Luis, Paco, hold them off. Get on board, Cisco, quickly! Let me help you! No!
Cipriano!
Get out of here!
But you are hit!
Down, Cisco, down! Martin, full speed ahead!
But Cipriano!
What did you think, darling? Cisco?
Hmm? Yes?
Were you asleep?
Me? No.
Your eyes were closed.
I always close my eyes when I listen to you play. I can see better.
Do you also snore?
Oh, I was not snoring.
I was watching. You seem to be so far away.
But I wasn't.
It happens so often, no matter where we are or what we're doing. I have this feeling that you've somehow slipped away from me and entered another world.
Another world?
Another faraway alien world.
My darling Emily, this is all your creative imagination.
Are you sure, Cisco? Oh, there, I've done it again.
You have done what?
I just did what I object to in others. I called you Cisco.
My name is Cisco.
Your name is Francisco. How can the head of the Department of World Literature at the university, that internationally renowned scholar, Dr. Francisco Canovas, be called Cisco? I mean, that's the name of some cowboy. The Cisco Kid.
Well, when I was young, I too wanted to be a cowboy.
Francisco, is everything all right?
Of course. And now we must get ready. We shall be late for your concert.
Do you think I was a little bit heavy on the pedal?
Oh, my darling, you were perfect.
All right, now it'll take me 30 minutes to dress.
Oh, at least.
Is this how you would speak to your first wife?
My first wife was not a concert pianist.
Well, what was she? What was she, Cisco? I've told you everything about me. Husbands and wives should have no secrets from each other.
That is a slogan, my dearest. How easily the world is taken in by slogans.
But... Look at the time. Are you all ready?
I must only put on a dark suit, a white shirt, and tie. That is scarcely a project.
Well, I'll be ready in 30 minutes.
I will time you.
But you always have the last word.
What was she like? What was my Maria like? She was like you, Emily. Your voice. Your face. And like you, fire burned inside her. But it was a different fire, a different flame.
I teach literature. What have I to do with revolution?
Literature itself is revolution. Literature is ideas, new ideas, a wave of concepts and feelings that beat against the established shores of complacency.
What you want me to do is to carry a gun.
I want you to speak and write and inspire other men and women to carry guns.
Why?
To overthrow this obscene government of thieves, murderers, and oppressors.
You turn those rascals out and you turn a new set of rascals in. It is what always happens.
It won't happen this time.
Why not? It is the history of the world.
Cisco.
Huh? Oh, Emily. Emily, what is the matter?
Who are you shouting at?
Shouting?
I distinctly heard.
Oh, no, no. My darling, it must be your imagination. Well, you can see there is no one here.
Don't tell me I didn't hear you.
Well, this is perhaps the most important concert of your career. You are understandably nervous. And it is good because you have to be keyed up. Now, go back upstairs. Better yet, I will go with you.
No, dear. You'll just be in the way. Just make sure you're ready.
Dear Emily, how can I tell you what she was like? I will have to go back there again. All the way back. And I don't want to. I can't. I won't.
Yes, I am coming.
Is this the home of Dr. Francisco Canovas?
Yes. What can...
No. No. It is Cipriano.
Yes. I am Cipriano.
You cannot be Cipriano. He was killed. I saw him die.
I am his son.
But you were only a child. Scarcely 5 years old.
I was 20. Yesterday.
15 years. Has it been 15 years? Oh, come in. What can I do for you?
It's not what you can do for me. It's what you must do with me.
And suddenly there is a chill that runs down the professor's spine. Deep in his heart, he knows what it is that he must do. Every day for the past 15 years, he has been expecting this moment and dreading it. Now it has finally arrived. A new clock must start to run. And it will shortly, when I shall return with Act Two. When we are young, the fires burn brightly. Those fierce fires of love, ambition, idealism. But in middle age, so often, the flames are banked and all but forgotten. Then much later, when we are old, we poke about the dead ashes, hoping that somehow, somewhere, there is still a tiny and feeble but glowing ember.
Cipriano.
Yes, I am Cipriano. And you are Dr. Francisco Canovas.
It has been so long. 15 years since it all happened. But I have kept faith with my old comrades.
Your dead comrades.
I know. They made it possible for me to come here to write, to work. To work for our cause at home, and I have done that.
Yes.
I have never missed a single opportunity to speak against, write against that foul and obscene Calomardi, the butcher. He has already slaughtered everyone who could rise against him.
Everyone, except you and me.
There is no longer an organized resistance, or any kind of resistance, is there?
No.
Tell me about yourself. First, your mother.
Dead.
Oh.
They took her away. After you escaped, she was never seen again.
And Luis? Paco?
Everyone is dead. But you...
But you are alive. I am so glad you have come to me. I am your godfather, you know. Tell me, what are your plans? Before you even tell me, have you any money, any prospects? You must live here. We have plenty of room. This big house, and we never had children. Do you want to go to school?
No.
What do you want to do?
Go back.
To where?
To Arias.
Arias? Why?
It is my native land. Your native land.
How can you go back then? You are the son of Cipriano Valdez. The butcher will have you killed.
He'll have to find me first.
His depraved police are everywhere. Where do you think you could hide?
In the hills.
The hills? You would go to the hills alone?
With you.
With me?
That is why I came here, to ask you. Come back with me.
No. I went to the hills 25 years ago.
And now the time has come to go again.
What could I do there?
what you did before.
I am 55 years old.
That doesn't matter.
It doesn't. You say that from the vantage point of a 20-year-old body.
When you and my father began the movement, there were men with you who were 50, even 60.
Yes, but they had 25-year-old hearts and souls and dreams.
Yes, so you're not even... excuse me.
Darling, may I present my godson? Cipriano Valdez. Cipriano is my wife, Emily.
I didn't know you had a godson. And does that make me your godmother, Cipriano? Oh, I'd love that. Tell me.
Later. Right now, please, give us 10 minutes, darling. I will change. Cipriano needs a shave. Emily is a concert pianist. We shall hear her play tonight.
I am not going
to. Oh, nonsense. Your father would never miss an opportunity to listen to music. Come along. We must go back inside, Cipriano. She has already started the second half of the program.
We cannot talk inside.
What is left to talk about?
Everything.
Are you serious about going to the hills?
The hills of Arias, where the revolutions are born.
I know all that.
In the hills of Arias, we find the roots of the people and the strength of the people.
I wrote all that.
And I believe all that. And
I believe it too, naturally.
Then come back to the hills.
Let me understand. The two of us are to go to the hills and start the revolution?
25 years ago, just two people went into the hills and did that very thing. You and my father.
Ah, those were different days.
You forget, perhaps. My father and all your friends died to set you free. So that one
I
day...
I did not ask to set me free.
You would have perished in that prison of hunger and disease.
Then they should have let me die. I am no longer a hero. Don't you understand?
It is not necessary for you to be a hero. You only have to be a man.
Listen to me.
I have no time to listen. There's too much to be done.
Yes. That is your father talking.
I shall be going back home on Friday.
That is the day after tomorrow.
With you or without you?
You would go back alone
25 years ago. You would have gone alone. I will see you Friday evening. I have a boat. Goodbye.
Cipriano, come back here.
Alone at last. Now you can tell me, darling, how was I? Darling.
Huh? Oh, yes?
You've gone away again.
No. Oh, you asked me how you did. You were superb.
Really?
Would I lie to you?
Without compunction. But I believe you this time. I always know when it goes well. Whatever happened to Cipriano?
Oh, he had a date.
When are we going to see him again?
Well, that depends.
On what?
Oh, various things.
In other words, you don't care to tell me. That is a part of your past I'm not supposed to know about.
Now, why do you imply that I have some deep, dark, hidden secret?
Don't you?
You make me out to be a man of mystery. What is there you don't know about me? You know everything.
Everything?
You know, I went to school in England, in Cambridge. You know, I returned to my country, Arias.
I thought the United States was your country. Didn't you become a citizen?
At the time, Arias was my country. You know, I became part of a revolutionary movement that overthrew the monarchy.
Yes.
And that the revolt, which was supposed to bring peace and freedom, only created a dictatorship. A dictatorship that was as bad, even worse, than the old one.
Yes.
I was lucky. I escaped with my life. I came here. I met you. I fell in love with you. I married you. Now... Is not that the whole picture?
No. It's just the candid snapshot in black and white, and missing are the colors and the shadings, the shadows. What did that boy Cipriano want?
He wants me to go back to Arias.
But if you went back to Arias, you'd be shot.
To the hills of Arias. And we would start a movement to overthrow the government.
Is the boy mad?
Well, it has been done before. I should know. I have done it myself.
Are you saying that the boy is serious?
Well, you saw him. He is a very serious young man.
Are you going?
How can you ask such a question? Of course I am not going. What did you think?
Oh, Cisco. There are times when you frighten me.
I know. There are times when I frighten myself.
He looks to be such a nice young man.
He reminds me of another nice young man I knew 25 years ago.
His father?
His father, yes. He looks like his father. He talks like him. But in a very strange way, he does not remind me of his father. He reminds me of someone else.
Who?
It does not matter. And besides, I am not even sure. Why are we talking about me on this night of your great triumph? Thank you for seeing me, Dr. Kurtz.
You said it was an emergency.
Today is Thursday. I must know what to do by tomorrow night.
Do? About what?
About the course of the rest of my life.
Cutting things rather fine, aren't you?
Perhaps. I should have come to see you 10, 12 years ago when I started having the dreams. Or are they dreams?
I don't know. Suppose you tell me.
Who am I, Dr. Kurtz? What do you know about me?
Well, I know you're my colleague on the university faculty. Highly praised, popular professor of literature. Once involved in a revolution in a small South American country, I think it was called Arias. You'll have to tell me the rest.
Very well, Dr. Kurtz. As completely and as concisely as I can.
Cisco!
Yes, yes.
It's almost midnight.
Yes, I know, I know.
12 hours ago, we were supposed to meet for lunch.
Yes, my dear.
At the faculty club. I waited there.
I am so sorry.
Well, are you all right?
Yes, yes.
Where were you?
I went to see Dr. Kurtz.
Kurtz?
He is a clinical professor of psychiatry at the medical school.
Oh?
I was long overdue. We were supposed to have an hour. It ran into nearly six. I could not stop talking. He could not stop listening.
And when it was all over?
I still have to make the decision.
To do what?
Whether or not to go back to the hills of Arias.
Shouldn't I have something to say about that?
Do you want to?
No. They're your hills.
I have decided. The hills are a lost youth. And youth must be lost in any event.
You're not an old man.
But I'm too old for the hills.
Oh, Cisco.
Oh, another thing. Do not call me Cisco.
Why not? Isn't your name Francisco?
Then call me Francis or Frank.
All right, if you want me to.
Dr. Kurtz did not tell me anything I did not know. He only helped me to formalize a decision I had already made.
And how do you feel?
Good. I mean that. It is bad enough to live in the past, but to die in the past.
Is it gone, finally?
It will never be gone. But it will take its rightful place as a memory. Sacred and beloved memory, but a memory.
Francisco, are you hungry?
I am starved.
All right, then I'll warm up dinner.
Good. What is in the oven?
Oh, of all things, Yankee pot roast.
What are we? Those of us who dwell here. All of us have come from somewhere. Some have come early, some late. In some, the memory and experience of another place is dim, distant, and almost dead. In others, it is fresh, green, and even poignant. But in all of us, the roots that stretch back to that other place are never, ever completely severed. Whether we know it or not. I shall return shortly with Act Three. Those who dream by day, said Mr. Poe, are cognizant of many things which escape those who only dream by night. But then, of course, we have those who dream at any time, and even all the time. One would imagine that nothing at all ever escapes them. Nothing at all except reality. And it doesn't matter, because they have already escaped from that.
Emily?
I'm here.
Oh, good, good. I wanted to see you before you left.
Now, the tour only runs 6 weeks.
Only?
And you'll see me at the beginning of the month in Los Angeles, won't you?
Yes, the lecture series has been arranged finally.
So we'll have a whole week together on the West Coast.
You will let me drive you to the airport.
Oh, no, no, no. That's Barton's job. Let my manager earn his money.
Is there a time for lunch?
Certainly.
Was there any mail?
Oh, yes. Will you become honorary chairman of, I forget the name of the committee. It's there on your desk.
How many committees am I on now?
10, 12, 15.
Well, what is one more, huh?
Oh, and remember, you're having lunch at the Masons tomorrow.
Ah, which means I will have to play tennis with Henry.
Since he's president of the university, you might let him win once in a while.
I cannot compromise my principles.
Yeah, but do you have to manifest such savage joy while you're beating him?
I suppose there is something about an authority figure that brings out the beast in me.
Oh, Cisco. Frank. Everything's all right, isn't it?
Of course, darling. Of course.
My watch must be slow. That's Barton. I have to go now, darling. I'll see you in 3 weeks.
Yes.
Cisco, I
told you my name is Frank.
No, 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 it doesn't sound right.
Darling, what is it?
I have this feeling suddenly, this terrible feeling. I'll never see you again.
Oh, how can you say that?
I just have this feeling.
Oh, my dearest.
Don't leave me.
I will never leave you.
Promise?
I promise.
I won't go. I'm going to call off the tour.
Why?
I'll stay here with you. I won't let you out of my... No, no, that's not the way to do it.
Darling, you must tell me what...
I also have dreams, Cisco.
Oh, my darling, this is no way for you to leave.
Cisco, whatever you do, I'll still love you. I'll always love you.
Emily. Yes, yes, yes. All right. Come in, my friend. Sit down.
I have come here for your answer.
The answer is no.
I see.
What do you see? What? Cowardice? Weariness? Cynicism?
I have not come here to judge.
But you will just the same.
You're willing to fight, or you're not. If you are, nothing further need to be said. If you're not, it all becomes meaningless conversation. You're for the revolution, or against it. Goodbye, then.
Goodbye, Cipriano.
Cisco, how can I do it alone? Tell me, how?
My son, what is there to tell you?
Why won't you come with me?
Because...
You went with my father.
It is because I am not Cisco anymore. You must understand that. I have lived here so long. Almost as long as I did in Arias. My life is here. My love is here. My work is here.
How could you change?
We all change. That is the tragedy of the world. We all become someone else. Calamard, I knew him when he was 20, your age. He could not wait to die for all humanity. How he changed. Now he cannot wait to murder all humanity.
My father would never have changed.
Your father died young. I should have died young, too. All idealists should die young. When the flower is in full bloom before it withers and lives on, somehow shriveled and decayed.
I will go back there alone.
I can tell you 1,000 reasons why you should not. Good, sound reasons, the same reasons that were told to me so many years ago. But I would not listen to them either.
Goodbye, Cisco.
Yes. Goodbye, Cipriano. Cipriano.
Halt! Who goes there?
What? Where?
Where am I?
The password. Identify yourself.
What is this?
Quickly.
I am Cisco, Francisco Canovas.
Stand still. Corporal de Guard, post number 3. I have the prisoner.
What prisoner?
Shut up.
I know you. The prison guard. Your name was Diaz. What am I doing here?
Step inside.
Oh, but
inside that door.
But it is dark in there.
Inside.
Francisco Canovas.
It is Maria. My wife, Maria.
I am not your wife any longer. I am dead.
Francisco Canovas.
And Cipriano, my oldest friend.
I am dead, Francisco.
I saw your son. The boy, he looks just like you, Cipriano.
Francis Canovas.
Luis. Francisco Canovas. Paco.
We are all here, Francisco.
Where? Where are we, Maria?
We are in a court of justice, Francisco.
A court of justice? Why?
To try a case.
Whose case?
Yours.
What have I done?
You have done nothing, Francisco.
Then why am I being tried?
You are guilty of the greatest crime of all.
But you just said I have done nothing.
Exactly. I call the first witness, Cipriano Valdez.
I am Cipriano Valdez. Almost 30 years ago, I went into the hills of Arias with Francisco Canovas. We raised the army that overthrew the monarchy. Now, another army must be raised to overthrow the tyranny. He refuses to lead it.
Cipriano, I cannot do it again.
You will allow my son to go alone, to die? We need you.
I have already done my share.
You cannot say that while there is still the breath of life in your body.
It is over. Listen to me. It is all over.
It is never over. Not while there is tyranny. You must not lose hope. You must not lose heart.
Don't be afraid, Cisco.
Can you really enjoy your life, your sweet and comfortable life, when we are dead and Calamar death still rules?
Don't you understand? By now it is useless. We will go to the hills again. We will organize the resistance again. We will fight again, win again, and then we shall lose again.
No, Cisco, not this time.
I can show you. Have I the right to call a witness?
You have every right.
Then I call Juan Batista Calomarde.
No!
Never!
You call upon that butcher to come here to defile this place, this sacred home of our hallowed dead.
I call upon the young Juan Batista Calomarde. He was one of us. He was part of us. And he has the right to be here in his youth.
Cisco and Cipriano, we're here. When do we march to the capital?
You remember him like this, Maria? Cipriano with the fiery color?
What are you trying to tell us?
You will see, Cipriano. I call upon your son, your 20-year-old son, the young Cipriano Valdez.
You are for us, or you are against us.
You see him? You hear him? He stands next to Juan Batista Calomarde. Can he become another Calo? You hear the same fury in their voices. You see the same fire in their eyes.
My son would never betray his comrade.
No, didn't we all wager our lives on Calo?
Cisco.
Once again, we shall be betrayed.
But you don't know that.
It is the history of the world.
Oh, you keep saying that, but history is not ordained. History is made by living, breathing men and women.
We were fooled the last time.
Yes, but we were young. Now you are older and wiser. You shall not let this happen again. Your wisdom, your experience this time. We shall succeed.
Don't ask me, please.
We must ask you.
We must ask you, Cisco.
And I know why. You are angry. Because I survived. You did not. You died, all of you. Now you want me to go back so I can die too.
No, Cisco, that is not true.
Especially you, Maria. Especially you.
You are jealous of her. Of Emily.
No. I love her because she has made you happy.
You hate her because she shares my life now, not you. You hate her because she is young, beautiful, and alive. It all comes down to the same thing. You are all angry with me because I survived.
You're the one whose voice is raised in anger.
Are you angry with yourself, Cisco?
I was willing to die. I never avoided death. I was in the forefront of every battle.
Cipriano, the night I escaped, we were in the water. The police bullets were all around us. They could have struck me. They struck you. Was it my fault? I was spared. Why? I do not know.
But you do know, Cisco. You were spared so that one day you could fight again.
No!
Go to the hills of Arias with the boy. Show him. Show them, all who will seek you out there, how it is done.
We will be with you.
How can I go back?
All of us are going back. The dead and the living.
Maria, Maria.
And this time, Cisco, become the leader. Hold the power.
Become the leader. Hold the power. Can you be sure I shall not become another Kahlo?
We are sure.
How can you be sure? I am not even sure. There may be demons in me, hidden secret demons that I never knew about, and then we would lose again.
Yes, we lose again.
So what is the use of
it? Oh, nowhere it is written that we must win, that we shall not be betrayed. We only know that we must fight.
I don't know what to do.
Do what is in your heart.
I don't know what is in my heart. I don't know what is in my heart. I don't know what is in my heart. I don't know. What? There's a telephone. Hello?
Cisco.
Yes.
Oh, I wanted to let you know I've arrived safely in Chicago.
Oh, good.
Did I wake you up?
Yes, 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 you did.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It is all right. It is time I woke up.
Time you woke up? What's up? Oh.
Darling?
You've decided, haven't you?
Yes.
Will you give my regards to Maria and Cipriano's father and Paco and Luis?
How do you know these names?
I've heard them every night for the past 12 years. I know everything about them, darling. And everything about you.
Then you know that I have no choice. I have to go.
Yes, you must do what's in your heart. Darling, let me ask you one thing.
What is it?
Wait for me.
And he went back. She went with him. And they are now in the hills of Arias. One day in the near or the distant future, he will march out of those hills for the second time at the head of a revolutionary army. And the revolt will succeed, probably, just as it did the first time. Then, depending on human nature, it will be betrayed, or it won't. I shall return shortly. Of Arias. You can think of them as a geographic location, or you can see them, perhaps, as a mystic place that exists somewhere in the psyche of each of us. A private, a secret place where our thoughts are born, our hopes are nourished, and our dreams are revealed. Yes, within all of us are these hills, and may yours be always verdant, fertile, and fruitful. Our cast included Mandel Kramer, Marion Seldes, Bob Caliban, and Ray Owens. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now a preview of our next tale.
I'm glad to hear you say that, Cornelius, but the facts indicate otherwise.
What facts? Innuendos, yes, well, maybe, but what facts?
At this point, Cornelius, I can only divulge them to the district attorney. If it all proves untrue, I can only say I'm sorry.
Ah, what does your sorrow mean to me? Once the story is in print, the damage is done.
I'll be glad to apologize.
Retractions mean nothing. I'll see you in court.
Oh, yes, you will.
But before I go, I might inform you that everything you were told by Ken Bradley at the bank is without foundation. If you think it was to my advantage to have my best client dead because I stood to gain money or was in debt or made injudicious investment decisions on behalf of my client, you'll have a hard time proving it.
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by White Westinghouse Appliance Company. This is Tammy Grimes, inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time.